Hello everyone, welcome to Bond Bytes, daily bond market highlights from INA Bonds. I'm Nikhil. In today's market highlights, during the weekend we have seen through the help of the Swiss government, UBS was able to crack the deal to buy Credit Suisse at close to $3 billion, which is a fraction of market cap or as of a Friday valuation. As of Friday valuation, the Credit Suisse was valued at close to $8 billion, but after that as the crisis deepened, the government stepped in and asked UBS to buy it out at $3 billion valuations. Given that the UBS and Credit Suisse deal, we would manage $5 trillion worth of wealth management assets globally, and which is interestingly three times the GDP of France. The repercussions of this deal is first angle is the CDS spreads, right? So this, since it's a credit event, the issuer of the CDS spreads would have to pay the hefty amounts to the holders, and it would cost in 2008 it even caused bankruptcy of few insurance companies due to the issuance of CDS spreads on the banks, and the banks defaulted at the time and they had to pay billions of dollars to compensate the holders of CDS. So this would have some kind of effect for the issuer who issued the CDS of Credit Suisse. And also the perpetual bonds have been written off the close to value of $17.3 billion. All the bondholders' wealth has been vanished in just over the time, as the perpetual bonds carry the risk of write off risk in a case of a credit default event. So, the US Federal said that with the multiple central banks, they would use the swift transfer of money to ensure the liquidity is enough into the market, which also indicates the banks, the interbank crisis have been deepened because of the banking crisis going on. This shows that the banks are no more trusting each other bank, and they have no clarity on what kind of positions each bank is sitting on. So because of this riskiness, the interbank rates in US would see some tightness, which is why Fed said that they will step in to provide the liquidity if necessary. Before we go to the bond market highlights, I would request you to check out our quick invest app by INR Bonds, which is available on both App Store and Play Store. Use our app to get the best curated list of bonds in the market and the best rates. These bonds are perfectly fit for the environment of rising inflation and as well as the interest rate rising scenarios.
It was a tough journey going from an intern to a senior professional. Now, to protect my savings against high inflation and grow my wealth, I invest in bonds with INR Bonds. Download the INR Bonds app to save better.
If you're a financial advisor, check out our partner portal where you can place bids on offer on behalf of your clients and give your clients the best bonds available in the market, which will help you to grow your assets under advisory.
As a financial advisor, my biggest responsibility is to help my clients make the right investment choices. Now, with INR Bonds, buying and investing in bonds for my clients is quick and easy. With my guidance on bonds, my clients are happy and I'm getting new business every day. Register as a financial advisor on INRBonds.com to help your clients invest and save better through bonds.
Coming back to the highlights, today the new tenure closed at 732 and the old tenure is at 733 and the 4-year is 719. The yields declined on the back of the sharp fall in the global oil prices. The oil prices declined as the investors expect, they don't really expect the central banks to go and supply liquidity into the market. And the equities front, the global equities are seeing a lot of volatility because of banking crisis. Domestic equities closed by 1% down, and the USD-INR pair is flat, traded on a flat note. And on the global front, 10-year USD is traded at 336 levels. In the corporate bond market space, Bajaj Finance issued 10-year bond at 8.08% and Muthoot Finance issued 3-year bond at 8.65%. Thank you for listening in. Do check out our app and subscribe to our YouTube channel if you are not done so already. Thank you.